breakfast battle. I'm Tony Lightfoot. On my left, to your right, Aaron Davies. On my right and to your left on the screen is Corey Vaughn. Say hi to the folks.
Hey, everybody. If you're watching in the States, you're up really early or stayed up really late. But I hope you're tuning in. And there's always that rewind button. So thank goodness for YouTube and Vince's brilliant broadcasting. You can catch us when you do wake up.
And what about you, Aaron?
Yeah, just thanks to everyone who's tuned in this morning. Especially to all, if there is any Americans watching. You got up really early. Europeans, thank you for tuning in and glad to have you.
All right then, so some good representation from Europe and from the Americas. And one game that we actually premiered at the Lake 38 Pro-Am just a few weeks ago was a little game called Pick Your Pass. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if we can get you in union. Let's play
Pick Your Pass.
All right, Aaron, what pass would you like to see?
So, there was a really interesting... There's a few passes that were really good yesterday, but I think it would be, I think Jacob's 39 in his second round, the 10-7 pass, quite an epic crash, so let's see that one again.
All right, let's spin that replay, shall we, with Jacob's fall on this pass. What was that? 10-7-5.
10-7-5. You know, he gets actually a really decent start, just trying to, you know, comes out of two, just gets pulled forward out of two, and he kind of has that Whitney McClintock style of crash that we saw at Worlds last year. He's
very much
like his ski, you know, went underneath him and his head went down first. So it's good to hear that he's okay.
Took a big old headshot in the noggin. No?
Yeah, he's got a big bump on his head. He had us all feel it. We all watched this maybe once or twice on Instagram yesterday, and that was a serious crash. We hope if anything like that happens again today, that the safety boat replies a little faster.
All right, before we get to your choice, let's check in with Lorenzo's land for the first time today.
Welcome back to the dock, everybody. We're here with Alice, our first skier of the day. So Alice, how are you feeling? How was last night? Did you rest? Are you pumped for today?
Yeah, honestly, I'm enjoying this trip so much. Everyone is so nice. I'm having fun with all the skiers all together. Had a good night of sleep, and today I'm gonna be the first one. Honestly, I'm just gonna enjoy it. I kind of did a score yesterday, so today is mostly like technique, getting it right, and hopefully running this 11 for the first time at this tournament. But we'll see. Honestly, enjoying it.
All right. And then today we just see that the conditions are just perfect. So are you a little more happy about that than yesterday?
Yeah, honestly, I was concerned yesterday about the wind, but then I still skied pretty good. I'm gonna start again at 14 today since there's no wind. And just get it going.
All right, perfect, Alicia. We'll let you get ready as the boat leaves the dock. Good luck, and back to you, Tony.
All right, excellent stuff then. Just a quick reminder to you folks out there, you can start to vote for your skier of the day. The skier of the day gets this wonderful, wonderful prize sponsored by 2U and Nutritional Bars. And you can go there at waterskibroadcasting.com/play to go vote. Now, your choice, Corey, for Pick Your Pass. What was your choice?
Well, we had a couple of tumbles. We'll leave Aaron out of it for now since he's here in the booth. But the other nice little tumble over the front was Nick Parsons. I'd like a second look at that one.
All right, let's spin that replay. Oh, and the problem started even before he got into the course.
Yeah, you see him leaning out on the rope there. The same thing happened to me, honestly, in that second round. Even after we had, here we go, front catches. Woo, Superman. And there comes the scorpion tail coming after his head. But I did the exact same thing. We had a 32 off opener from that same end. We learned that the headwind was strong and slowing you down on the gate. Yet even again, on that second pass pulling out, I got caught by the wind. You saw it there, Nick, leaning against the boat the whole time.
Yeah, I definitely did the same in that headwind. And I mean, in the tailwind as well, I thought I pulled out way too early. And I ended up being a little bit late. But that just tells you how strong that wind was in that second round yesterday. We all underestimated it a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, so what we were looking at here on the webcast didn't quite show it. Maybe even what was on the water as skiers didn't fully show it. It was maybe more on the body. And that can happen sometimes. But today we're back to glass calm, which is what we had every day since Tuesday. And apparently that wind we had yesterday was like a 5 days a year sort of event here. So glad we got it out of the way and it's not the finals with all of us jumping over the front of the ski.
I think the thing that would emanate the conditions yesterday is Will Asher coming in after his 12-meter pass. Like he went, okay, I'm not going to ski anymore. That's going to be it. And that was more for safety concerns, I think, than anything else. Just he's like, I do not want to get injured. So that emanates the conditions that we had yesterday. You know, Will saying, hey, you know, it's not quite safe enough to ski, so let's just take it in, rest up for tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I thought about that after both of the first two passes. I've never done that, so my goal after being the one after Jacob was just to get back to the dock safely, and that happened, so we go today.
Right.
All right, then. You two have had a shot at pick your pass. Here's mine. Will's attempt to run in 41 off. Let's have a look at that if we can. Let's spin that replay. And started off with a really, really good coast and glide into number one there.
Well, we've seen Will each of the last three tournaments, including this one, go out in the first round and put up a huge score. I want to say San Gervasio and Botas, he put up 5 in the first round. So, and he was on pace for 5 here. You're going to see there's a big difference between squeaking outside of 4, which he did not, and getting the pull right here all the way to 5. He thought he was turning that and came up just a tad short, but he was in that pass to run it. So Will's obviously very dialed in over here in Europe, and you know, he's going to be looking for those last two buoys today.
Is that enough to earn your vote for skier of the day? Well, maybe. Having seen that, maybe you're inclined. Yep. So you gotta put your vote in for skier of the day. Waterski Pro, waterskibroadcasting.com. Go /play. waterskibroadcasting.com/play. Go vote for skier of the day.
I tell you what I'd like to see. I'd like to see Alice go out here first off the dock in the ladies, run the 11, which she's been just so close to every weekend so far. She's just an inch or a centimeter away from breaking through that. That could be a skier of the day right there. Go ahead, throw out, you know, a solid 2 or something at 10-7, put the pressure on the rest of the pack. You're looking at potentially a skier of the day right off the dock.
Right, yeah, you know, just putting that, just, I mean, those two boys on that 10-7 pass, that's a lot of pressure for the girls to get out there and get out to that 3-ball. That's the difference.
Well, and even Jamie, who's been so dialed in, who's the world champion, who's won the stops so far on this tour, you know, if Alice goes and puts 2, which she's capable of doing, Jamie, as consistent as she is, she knows she's got to get off a 1-ball solidly, and if she's going to have to go to 3, you're not safety turning 1-ball, you're turning 1, and this is 10-7. So by getting a score like that, all of a sudden the whole calculation changes for everyone.
Yeah, I know. I think we've both been in that same position where you know you've got to get a score like 3 or 4, and you go, I got to get the start here. But that's the pressure, is getting that start on that pass. So we'll see what she can do here today as she sets off from the dock, ready to set down before her first pass.
Yeah, Alice and I think we both have a similar warm-up routine. I've noticed that we're kind of warming up at the same time. And
a little
have
bit
our,
of plyometrics. Yeah.
Yes, our whole extensive stretching mobility routine. So I appreciate that. You got to get that body ready, and I'll be wishing her the best for sure.
All right, then. And for my money, Alice's point of where success starts for her is basically number 3 on 11.25 meters. She normally does pretty good with the start off number 1 and coasts pretty well into that number 2. You even made the comment in wanting to see her a little bit more aggressive off the edge change and go full extension a little bit earlier. But for me, her success or failure going forward is going to be all determined on that turn on number 3.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you. I think that what I'm looking at is to set herself up for the 3-ball that she needs. She has such a strong automatic left foot forward skier turn at 3. I think if she can be a little swifter in and out of that 2-ball, she's going to be arriving at 3 at a place and at a time that allows her to just stay ahead of the course and know that she can get through the end without losing any distance.
All right, talk is done, action is now. Here we go with Alice Bagnoli with 14.25 meter start. Let's see how she gets along. Nice load off number 1. She always has that, you know. She drops everything in and then uses her strength.
She just has such a strong onside. You see, like, coming out of 135 there, just really getting set and just whipping herself over to the next boy across course.
Yeah. All right, let's check in once again with Lorenzo's land.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Beatrice, our second skier in the water. So, Beatrice, how are you feeling today?
Great. Like, today the conditions are great and even better than yesterday, so I really can't wait to be in the water.
All right, perfect. So, Last night we all had a good dinner all together. Did you enjoy this Greek vibe, Greek spirit that we're experiencing right now?
Yeah, I mean, it's so much fun. Everybody's very nice here. Food is great. It's amazing. It's I'm having a blast here.
All right, perfect. Beatrice, we're going to let you get focused. Best of luck, and back to you, Tony.
All right, then, some great comments there from Beatrice Yanni. And that comment there on the amazing food in Greece, that's almost sacrilegious, isn't it?
I know, like, she's Italian. She's like, Italy is the home of food and great food. I know we had great food last week in San Gervasio, and she's come over and said the food's great in Greece, so it is really good food over here as well.
Yeah, she can't lie. We've been on just over a week now of amazing food touring, and here's Alice, 13 meters. Really, she opened it this past yesterday and looked amazing, so we're expecting just a feel, a dial in here. Let's kind of watch this 2-4. That was tighter, actually, than even the opener. This is what we're saying. I think a lot of the 38 hinges on. That was actually better. So that's the advantage of starting at 14, having a 13 to maybe another easy pass, just to feel some things out, get those little tiny nuances dialed in. And looks like maybe she's doing that. Hopefully we see it continue at 12 meters.
Yeah, I think like one of the things with her amazing onside on that 135, she's just got to be so careful that she doesn't get on it way too soon. I think that's something that hinders her a little bit when it comes to the shorter short line passes, such as at like 11, is that she comes out of that 135 so strong, and it is a really, really good turn, but she just has to be so careful not to get pulled up after the second weight towards 2-4.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Jeff Rogers comes to mind, or an Aaron Larkin. Big, strong lefty turns, like, so cool to watch. But then what's so good on the one side can take away from the other side. It's a little bit easier to get disconnected off of the second wake if you're carrying all that load and trying to bring that through the edge change. So that's what we're looking for. So all of that direction, but maybe not all of the load right at the backside. Just a continuous progressive drive into center, so that she can ride that line up and get a nice free break off of the line into 2-4.
Right. So she'll be coming back now on the 12-meter pass. You know, it ramps up a little bit. This is where it becomes really short line skiing. You're only just wider than the course, so 50 centimeters. So
I like the gate.
Yeah, it's a nice gate. And
good hookup.
Just a little hesitation there out of two, but look at that strong 135.
There we go. I like that commitment at 4.
Yeah.
I feel like that's what she's going to need at the 2 ball at 38. Just ride that handle out off the wakes for a moment and to the end of the line and commit.
You know, it's kind of similar to what we said yesterday. Is when you get that second turn, you know, off that 2 ball, you're all right, I've done one good turn at 1, and I've done another good turn at 2. That's the game changer, I know, for myself in my head. Okay, I've got out of 2, game's on. You know, rather than scrapping it, we can kind of just stick on the autopilot.
Right, you've established a rhythm, then it's just stay with that rhythm, try not to make any changes. Don't dial it up, don't dial it down. So that's what we'll be looking for here. I like what she's doing on the gate so far.
Yeah, really nice wide gate, free of the boat. She can get a ski under the line and just get going before the boat starts to pull her towards the gate.
There, I see our Flow Point Method banner at the bottom of the screen again. Very proud to be part of what Marcus and Jenny are doing with the Flow Point Method. And I can't say enough good things about that, not only through the on-season and the community that they've created online, the calls, but also the off-season workouts. It's made a difference for me getting through the season without being dinged up.
I mean, I'm not on the Flow Point Method myself, but from some of the little highlights that they post on Instagram, it looks like an amazing stuff, and I've definitely took advantage of that. But here comes Alice on 11. Great gate. She's out of 1 strong. She's out towards 2. She's a little bit pulled forward at 2. Can she get outside of 3? Yeah, she can, but just S-turning it, just making it back to the wakes.
Looked really powerful through that gate, potentially almost too much speed bringing into the course. She's able to bring that speed through her 135 side because she turns it so well. But let's see right here. So strong right there. Almost that extra boost of speed across the back of the boat. Brings it through right there. But now look how much power and speed are rolling to 2. That's harder to control.
Yeah.
Then you see that loose line right there, a little pulled up.
And then she nearly did similar to what she did yesterday with that tip going down.
Yeah, that little pull forward at the connection there, you know, I think she's just not quite aligned on the ski the way she wants to be, and then she hits the trough of the wake there or something, and that little pitch, she maybe could have made it up there at three ball minus that little wobble off of the wakes. That is a powerful gate shot.
Yes, indeed, and a number of people are watching this across the world, including Fedele Luzzeri, who is recuperating in the hospital right now, our venerable organizer of the San Gervasio, and it's good to see him message me here at the announcing point, and we wish him the very best of luck going forwards in his recuperation from back surgery.
We hear that he's back on his feet again, slowly. I think he walked a kilometer or something with a little bit of support, but great to hear he's back on his feet, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
All right, right you are. So the score for Alicia Bagnoli, it was 3 at 11.2. Okay, so that improves upon her second backup. So her first backup, is a best score is 4 at 11.25 meters. So there's that to take into consideration when we reseed this list going into the final round of championship pro skiing. Skier on the water is Beatrizia Jani.
Yeah, I mean, Bea is off to a strong start this year. You know, I'm getting to know her better on these trips, this trip in particular. I know she was kind of a little bit off the scene for a couple of years. I don't know, you know, probably just pursuing other things. But she's back this year, skiing really strong, looking really strong, obviously worked on her fitness. And I think with that, we're going to throw it over to Lorenzo.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Ali. We just saw Alicia finishing a run and Beatrice is in the water. So Ali, feeling pumped this morning?
Yeah, feeling pumped, feeling excited to be here. Conditions are perfect, so hopefully it stays this way all day.
All right, perfect. Yesterday, we saw you in second round posting an amazing score. Hoping to improve today?
Yeah, definitely hoping to improve. I thought that yesterday second round felt better than first, so hopefully third round and fourth round feel even better.
All right, perfect. So we'll let you get focused. Best of luck, and back to you, Tony.
Well, thank you very much, and just enough time to tell you about D3 Skis, the audience prize sponsor for the men. High-performance skis for all three events. They have two new slalom skis on the block. They've got the Neo and the Ion 2. You can find out more by going to d3skis.com, d3skis.com, the audience prize sponsor for the men's portion of that prize, waterskibroadcasting.com/play, and make sure though that entry is in. Here we go. This is Beatrizia Jani.
Yeah, coming in on 13 meters now. So she's going in on a line shorter than Alice. She obviously wants, you know, I think she goes out at 13 normally. So she just wants a normal set, just flowing from side to side, just doing what she does best.
And with that, let's check in with Lorenzo's land.
All right, we're here with Alicia at the dock. Alicia, what happened out there? I see that you're not so happy about your score.
Yeah, I'm a little sad. I didn't really feel quite settled. You know, I'm a strong skier, and I feel through the wakes I pull quite hard, and I need to feel a little bit of a hold. And through the wakes, I was just losing it a little bit and then reaching to the buoy a little in a weird position. So, yeah, that's it. Honestly, just not quite strong behind the boat today.
Okay. Well, you know what you did wrong. I'm pretty sure you also know what you need to do to get better in the final and post an amazing score, hopefully to get on that podium today.
Yeah, I guess here, you know, as I said, if I don't really feel the boat with me in the wakes, then I just need to follow it more and just, instead of over-leaning, just, you know, just stay there, stay in a strong position, but not extra lean, just a good lean out of the wakes, and yeah, that's it.
All right, Alicia, thank you very much. Go get rested, get focused for the next round, and back to you, Tony.
Why, thank you very much. And, you know, getting into that position to be able to take a ball across the back of the boat, it's like tug of war. You know, you can pull as hard as you can, but if your feet aren't set and they're not 90 degrees and rotating away from the opposition, then you don't stand much of a chance.
Yeah, I think what you're saying there is a matter of leverage. And you can kind of see right here, Bea is a little bit taller than Alice, so she has a little bit more natural leverage. And you can almost tell she's not as far away. Her shoulders aren't as far away from the boat as Alice's were. But, you know, she's riding with nice leverage right there, kind of getting enough power from the boat, everything that she needs. Of course, as the line gets shorter, the load on the rope is going to get more intense, and you've got to be ready to match that with your leverage.
And bearing in mind, she's skiing with a switch grip, which means essentially that she is right foot forward and right hand up. And that's a difference to what most people ski with that foot forward.
And she did that electively, right? She recently changed due to an injury?
Yeah, I believe she was on injury, and then that's the reason she switched. I think it was a shoulder injury or something.
And elbow.
An elbow injury. So I think just that having that rotation with the regular grip for the righty, she, excuse me, she's a little bit more comfortable that way. It does make you a little bit more twisted, but she seems to have adapted really, really well. And that, you know, that might have been part of the reason that we didn't see her on the tour for a while, on the pro scene. So good to see her come back. Got that new grip. She's adapted to it well. So good for her.
Yeah, I can speak to that. I was a reverse grip for 20 years. I just started out that way, eventually made myself switch to the other. And there are pros and cons to both. We had a mistake here. This is going to be 12 meters. So Bea actually started at 14 meters or 28 off. We got a little bit ahead of ourselves. So this is 35 off, 12 meters. I thought those early passes looked awfully casual, but still looking right on time for six right there.
And a skier who registered her first professional podium last week in San Gervasio. This is Beatrizia Jani doing a fine job on 14:13. And 12 meters, and Aaron, you know, the intensity ratchets up every single time that rope gets shorter, and you can just see that intensity across her face going into number one.
Yeah, you could see it in the first two passes. It was just kind of relaxed Bea, you know, stick on the cruise control, just, you know, flowing from side to side. And now the energy and has really ramped up. You can see it in her face and in her stance across the wake. You just see she's leaning a little bit more. Just making sure she's getting out nice and wide for those buoys. And then, you know, that difference between the 12 and the upcoming pass, 11.25, the rope is now shorter than the distance between the boat and the buoys. So, you know, that's you have to make up 25 centimeters in your width, in your grip, in your stance, which is hard. You know, never mind the next few passes, but we'll see what you can do on this 11.25 meter line.
Yeah, Bea, of course, has a little bit of height working on her side, but more than anything, as we know, it's technique. You need to be skiing in a rhythm that gets that handle close to the buoy, and that's a pretty good one right there. She's in this.
There you go, round number three. Ooh, and gets the three. That ties for Alicia Bagnoli with that particular score in there. They've actually tied each other pretty much all the way through, because both of those skiers have got two threes and a four.
Yeah, you saw right here, the one ball wasn't great. I'm sure she wished for more, but it also was something I thought maybe she could work with. I mean, a little hesitation, but I think the two was going to be the make or break. If she could have really ripped this two and found the line, see right there, losing the line a little bit, having to go a little long to three.
I think she also looked a little bit narrow on that two ball as well. You could just see her do a little bit of a double pump just to make sure she got around that two. So I think that, you know, I think that slight edge change into two, she came up a little bit narrow towards two, and I think that was the nail in the coffin, unfortunately. You see here out of one, just that momentary hesitation, and on these short lines, that's all it takes to just put you into panic mode. And you see she's just reaching really long for two. Yeah, I think just unfortunately 3 is all she wrote there for Bea.
Yeah.
You could tell coming into 3 in her mind she was still turning it. She wasn't going to just take 3, but then she could tell right away she had no rope to work with, dunked the handle in the water and stood it up for the full buoy.
Yeah.
So just to clarify in terms of the scores for Beatrizia Jani and Alicia Bagnoli, whereas Beatrizia Jani has scored two threes and a four, Alicia Bagnoli has scored a 2.5, a three, and a four. So only in 3 rounds of skiing, less than a buoy separates Alicia and Beatrizia.
Wow, that's a tight battle. That's going to leave it all to finals, and they're going to be out there fighting for it.
That's how close these girls are in competing against each other. Like, it's just such a close battle. you know, one boy after three rounds of skiing, that's nothing.
All right then, so we're on to our penultimate skier. We've just learned that that Jamie Ball will not be skiing in this third round, deciding to take a little bit of a rest here, much like Freddie Winter did in one of the rounds yesterday. And why strategy from your point of view, chaps?
Well, I think that Jamie's gone out there. She's gotten the feel of the boat. She did a lot of practice this week, so there really aren't any surprises. There's no wind to factor for. And I think at this point she's just thinking, play the strength game. You know, no reason to go out there, get your hands tired. This water is very warm. You know, you could rip a blister on your second pass, not even a hard pass. And she's trying to preserve her body to lay it all out there in the finals.
Yeah, and Ali Nicholson out there getting ready. And speaking of blisters, did you see that big old blister that Philippos Kyprios had? Oh, my word. It tore up half of his hand.
Oh, my God.
When you get the full flap, that's never good.
All right, let's check in dockside with Lorenzo's Land.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Beatrice, who just got done with her set. Bea, I saw a little bit of disappointment in your face. Tell us what happened.
Yeah, I mean, I felt great for the first passes, but like from 12, I don't know what happened. I think like 11, I didn't have that much speed at my gate. So I gained too much speed going on the first ball and when I went on my back pull, yeah, you know. But it's fine. I hope later it's going to be better.
All right. Do you think that this absolute absence of wind could play a role in this, in the feeling that both you and Alicia had?
Well, no. I mean, I think yesterday with a little bit of wind, it was a bit better. But, I mean, it's perfect out there.
All right. Perfect, Bea. Thank you very much. Get rested. Get ready for final. And back to you, Tony.
And we're back on the water. 13 meters. Typical starting line length for Ali Nicholson and consistent once again.
Giving a little wave there to her mom, who I think is on the bank over there.
Hi, mom.
Hey, she's been off on the adventures with us. She's been climbing the cliffs and jumping off near waterfalls. It's been amazing. It's been amazing for the whole group of us to be together for meals, excursions. That's something that I've been doing this for 12 years, and I can't think of another time where that's happened.
Yeah, it's been really good fun all week.
All right, just a quick reminder to tell you about Conley Skis. They are the audience prize sponsor for the women's competition. They have the DVS and Carbon V, both skis, each with the patented Versatel technology. Check them out at conleyskis.com. That is conleyskis.com. They are one of our webcast sponsors all season, and they sponsor the audience prize for the women where at any given time during these competitions on TWBC, you could put yourself in a position to win yourself a free slalom ski, courtesy of D3 and indeed Conley. We've also got the first of our matchups being put up on bplayfuel.com. Our matchups are now being uploaded to bplayfuel.com. That is bplayfuel.com. Let's go to Ali Nicholson and Aaron, take it away.
Yeah, this is an easy pass here for Ali so far. Make 12 meters, usually her second pass anyway. You know, looking really good, really strong. You see how she just hooks up, waits for the boat to pull her, and then zipping across the wake really early for the next buoy.
Yeah, we mentioned it yesterday that this is a new ski that she's only gotten on since she's been in Greece, and it certainly doesn't look that way. I believe I overheard her saying that as compared to her other ski, she really likes this toe side turn, this offside turn 2-4, I think even better. You can see right there, like perfect connection with the boat. She said maybe not quite as much on this 1-3-5 side, but that 3 I thought was a beautiful turn. I think maybe she's still finding her place on the ski round by round. So, you know, Ali may still be building into the finals right here.
Yeah, I think she's still, you know, she looks really, really comfortable on the ski. She looks like she's been on it for, you know, all season. I know she was making a few tiny, tiny little adjustments coming into today and the second round yesterday. And I think, you know, she's liking those adjustments she's made and she's stuck with those for today.
Nicely done. And looks like we got a first of our male skiers about to take to the water very, very soon. That's George Hatzis. And instrumental in getting this competition back after a many, many years absence from 2005. So glad to have his organization and his talents bringing this tournament back here to Caiaphas.
I think if you look on Marcus Brown's Instagram, you see the back the videos from the old Caiaphas. But if you look now on the water, we've got Ali on 11. You know, just a little momentary hesitation, but nothing she can't deal with, and she's getting this pass done out from five and out towards six.
Yeah.
You know, textbook skiing there from Ali.
What a great four ball to come into a toe side turn with that much confidence. I mean, she exited four on a better path than where she came in, and she was super early by six.
You just see here the power that she has. She's a tall girl. She's got that on her side. So looking really, really good. Just a momentary hesitation on that 2-4 side. I think that's just where she doesn't quite fully trust the ski yet.
Yeah, but look here, Aaron. This 4 ball I thought was really nice. Just coming full commitment. Got the line very quickly, and now early to 5. Didn't even have to think about it. I mean, she's waiting on 6 out here as if it's, you know, her opening pass.
Yeah. Looks so easy. Another textbook pass there from Ali, making it look good.
And that relegates her backup score of 5 and 11.25 meters to actually being the second backup. And her best score up to this point has been 2 at 10.75 meters. So into 39.5 off for the second round in succession. And finding her confidence on that ski, a stock Syndicate Pro.
Yeah, and let's see what she can do right here. Top score of the tournament is Jamie, 4 at 39. Let's see if Ali can start to get close to that. Good one.
Oh, amazing one there.
It looks still just a little long to 2 to me with those good ones.
Yeah, like that was a gooder one as anyone would want on that pass. We'll see what happened here going towards 2, but it looked like a really nice gate. Just so strong, out towards 1. Gets that ski under the line, gets going, there's no hesitation at all. Out towards 2, I think he just pulled a little bit long, couldn't get that ski slowed down just enough. You can see it there in her face, she knew that was a good one.
Yeah, it was an amazing hookup. I thought she had what she needed coming all the way into center. You could almost see it was like a very forceful drive through the body, like through the legs, right off of the second wake. And that's just some extra speed that's going to make 2 ball so difficult. Let's see if we can see it right there, that extra little push. I mean, it gets the ski way out, but I think it was going to be there for her anyway. I'd like to see her get off of that too. I mean, because if she can turn 3 anything like that 1 ball, she's going to 4, possibly more.
Yeah, she's such a strong skier. She's got so much talent, and just to see her get through that pass would be, you know, amazing. You know, we've still got the final this afternoon, so we'll see what you can do there.
All right, then, and there is your leaderboard after 3 rounds of pro women's slalom skiing. Jamie Bowles still in the lead with 4 at 10.75. Ali Nicholson with 2, and then Betritiani and Alicia Bagnoli are separated by half a buoy, each of them scoring a 4-4 for Betritiani, and Alice scoring a maximum of 4, but with an inferior backup. All right, got Corey Vaughan here. I've got Aaron Davies, and we're going to bring on our male slalom skiers in this, the Caiaphas Pro-Am Battle for 2022. We'll be back in moments.
Hi, my name is Brantley Hawkins. I'm one of the co-founders here at New Dimensions Wellness. My partner and I have over 20 plus years of sports medicine and exercise experience working with the most elite athletes in the world. Together, we have developed a proven system that has been sought out by these professional athletes and is now available to you.
You will move your body and loosen your joints in ways that you haven't before. It's not your typical weight training. It's not CrossFit, and it's not crunch fitness.
Once I got in here, it was a big eye-opener how much different that they go about everything.
Denali. No hype, just science.
What if I told you there was a place where the sounds of nature are only broken by the roar of a boat, a place where that summer feeling lasts all year long, a place where the Florida sun is only outshined by the smiles of the skiers, a place where first-time skiers can ski alongside world champions and the world-class coaches work with all levels of skiers. What if I told you there was a place where life slows down and your only job is to make lifelong memories? That place is Swiss Water Ski Resort. Book your trip at SwissWaterSkiResort.com.
Welcome back to the dock. We're here with Yorgo, our first skier of the day. First of all, Yorgo, thank you very much for putting up this amazing event. And how are you feeling today? Feeling ready to go?
Not only ready, you're going to see something absolutely amazing now. Stay tuned, please.
Okay. So you just told me that you wanted to say something. You had something important to say. So here's the mic. Speak your truth.
All right. Are you ready? Tell me, are you ready? All right. I forgot about it. Wait.
Back to you.
No, the other one.
Best of luck to me.
Best of luck to me. Back to you, Tony.
Thank you, Yorgo.
Oh, yikes. And it's been that kind of tournament, folks. It's been fun. It's been exciting. It's been everything that this competition has been advertised, and then some more. Tell you what, certainly one of the best experiences I've ever had at a tournament in a long, long time. And we've got George Hatzis taken to the water first, followed by Matteo Lazzari, Nick Parsons, Philippos Kyprios, Jakob Bonja. And then we got Corey Vaughan, Freddie Winter, Aaron Davies, Benjamin Stadelbauer, and finally Will Asher, the 10 skiers in this third round. And then after we get done with the third round, then we'll take a bit of a break and go to a new webcast player for the championship round of skiing. So that kind of gives you an idea of what's coming up in the immediate future. We got some electronic dance music playing in the background. We've got a lively crowd scattered across the facility, but none more so than around the dockside area. It is a rather large dock area with some seating, some lounge chairs, and all that kind of stuff. That kind of gives off a really, really nice and relaxed vibe going forwards as we explore the dock. And absolutely. And And those skiers looking to make an impression, this is the prize that they're after. It's the skier of the day, sponsored by 2U Nutritional Bars. And make sure you go vote to waterskibroadcasting.com/play. waterskibroadcasting.com/play to submit your vote for skier of the day. Could it be one of the pros, or could it even be this guy who's really, really stepped up for organizing this competition? So go vote for skier of the day, waterskibroadcasting.com/play. So, we got George Hatzis on the water, whether he's going to go in on 13 meters. I think, actually, according to Water Ski Pro Tour rules, the minimum starting line length is 13 meters, irrespective of where you go. But I'm guessing the only exception is if there are extenuating circumstances, conditions, and so forth. And with that in mind, let's check in with Lorenzo's land.
Welcome back to the dock. We're here with Matteo, our second man skier for today. So, Matteo, unfortunately, yesterday we saw Leo disappointed about your result. But tell us what you need to improve those scores.
A bit of precision. I think yesterday I might have gone aggressive in the wrong spots. Today the conditions are beautiful, as you can see. So I'm going to do a regular set, try to enjoy it more than yesterday, and get the boost that I need to make the final.
All right, perfect. But Matteo, yesterday you decided twice to go in at 12-meter line. Are you going to keep the same strategy today, or are you going to change it?
No, we're going to give a regular set at 13. There's virtually no wind. A lot of guys ran 10-7 on the way back, tailwind, so wind is not a factor. So I'm just going to do a regular set starting at 13.
All right, perfect. Thank you very much, Matteo. Get focused, and back to you, Tony.
Thank you very much. And taking a look at George Hatzis. Normally skis at 55K, but for this weekend, probably the only weekend this season, he's skiing at 58. Skiing with A2 and on 30 meters. Nicely done, much to the delight of our folks here, our Greek supporters here on the western Peloponnesian coast. Drops in and gets ready to shorten down to the 12 meter line. Just enough time for me to tell you about Summit Orthopedic. If you've got a skiing injury that you need to shake off, Summit will get you back to your peak again. Check out Summit Orthopedic online. That is Summit Orthopedic. Also check out online USA Water Ski and Wake Sports Foundation. They're working hard to preserve the heritage of tow water sports by maintaining the halls of fame both nationally in the United States and also internationally with the IWWF. And they're also providing scholarships to promising young athletes within the United States. So check them out. It is USA Water Ski and Wake Sports Foundation. There's your leaderboard. After two complete rounds, and we're deep into the third round. I'm going to have some assistance on the mic very, very soon from a good friend of mine. And George Hatz is getting in deep on 12. Now the conditions a little calmer than yesterday, but unfortunately just not able to get things rhythmically go his way. And Ali Nicholson, great to have you back.
Thanks for having me, Tony.
So let's see his gate shot. He gets good rotation, decent angle, but could have used with a little bit more to keep that ski working away and that line tight.
Yeah, it looks like he's kind of just moving there to the back of the ski at the end of the turn, never kind of getting his feet through. And I think that finally just kind of caught up to him as he went down the pass.
Right, you are. And that is going to be the four buoys. Does he get... Yeah, just about.
Yeah, it looks like four to me.
Indeed. It is four buoys on 12 meters, and one of the good folks that is helping to put this event on, and much to the delight of the pro skiers and also the amateur skiers who are skiing here this weekend. It's been quite a festival atmosphere, one would say.
Yeah, it's been fun, and we have quite the crowd out here, so it's pretty exciting to see, you know, getting the cheers and whatnot as we're skiing, and it's been a really fun weekend so far.
All right, then, as we get ready to bring our next competitor out, it's going to be Matteo Lizzeri. Let's talk about you for a little bit. I mean, you're probably like thinking to yourself, oh, my God, what question is he going to ask? But anyway, so you're taking a little bit of a break from your professional life as a traveling nurse, right?
That's right.
Okay, so how long of a break can you take?
I'm probably testing the limit a little bit. We're going to be right at about 4 months. Off, so I think whenever I get back from this trip, I'm going to start kind of looking, and I'm hoping to have something lined up in September.
Excellent stuff, and you know, it's one of those occupations in like the new normal in this day and age. I mean, like nurses and medical personnel these days. I mean, they're not like rooted to one medical center or hospital. Some are, of course, then, but now in this day and age, that you have. You have such thing as a traveling medic, such as yourself, and we'll go into that in a little bit more detail in a moment. Let's check in with Lorenzo's land first.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Jorgo after his third set. So, Jorgo, did you enjoy your set today?
I always enjoy myself. It wasn't what I was expecting, but you know, I keep all my energy for the finals.
All right, perfect. So you still have that aim of Freddy and Will?
Are you kidding me? Of course. Of course. And let me say it. Back to you, Tony, now.
Thank you, Jorgo. Back to you, Tony.
Oh, he's having way too much fun out there, isn't he?
I think he's trying to steal Lorenzo's catchphrase.
I think so. It's already enough that one skier has stolen my outro catchphrase.
Ciao for now. It's just so catchy.
Now you're trying it on. Anyways, so we're continuing on. Let's talk about the life work skiing work balance type deal because now in this day and age there are traveling medics, there are traveling nurses, you know, and that definitely helps you with your skiing going forward, doesn't it?
Yeah. So I've been very fortunate to find this kind of little area that I can do a little bit of both, so it's not super uncommon to see people take a couple months off. So I've been fortunate enough that I can do nursing in the off season, still train, and then come back and be able to do skiing full time here in the summer.
Excellent stuff. And let's have a look at Matteo Lizzeri's opening pass, 13 meters. Minimum starting line length. He has been started in on the 12 meter line for the last couple of rounds, and I think he's you know, he's that the novelty of that's kind of worn off on him a little bit.
Yeah, so looking at his scores from the first few rounds, that start didn't really work out for him. So I think he's going to try the different approach, try going in at 13 and see if we can get a higher result this time.
He scored 3.5 at 10.75 in round one and 2.5 in round number two. So looking to give himself a little bit of a jolt and get into 41 off, which he did on his home site at San Gervasio a couple of weeks ago. So he's looking for a similar kind of form here and see if he can't to try and move himself down a little bit on the starting list for the championship round that comes up after this.
Yeah, so I think, I mean, and he's done 12 for the two rounds yesterday. I think he's going to go out and try 13 today and see which one he likes more. So he kind of will have the strategy of doing both and making his decision for the final.
Right, you are. So, and there is Jakob Bonja from Sweden. So, all right then. So we got Jakob Bonja on the dock from Sweden getting ready for his go. He is going to have to stay patient though. So Matteo Lizzeri, 12 meters. Getting broken a little bit down course here, but still continuing to roll.
He got broken forward a little bit there at a three ball it was, but five looked much better for him.
Maybe a little bit of a wake-up call, I would say, because, I mean, he did that on the pass that would have been his opener had it been in round one or round two. So, you know, I mean, on 13 meters, which was his starting line length, he didn't have those stability problems going into number one as he did on the 12 meter. So maybe looking for a little bit more rhythm and not trying to use too much of his muscle to get him through his runs on the course.
Yeah, I know. I mean, starting at 12 has got to be kind of like that. That's a wake-up call.
All right, then. That in mind, let's check in with Lorenzo's land.
Welcome back to the dock. We're here with Jacob, our third skier on the water. So, Jacob, good to see you on the dock after yesterday's tumble. How are you feeling today?
I feel a little bit sore in my body, but excited to get out there and see how it feels.
All right. Also, you just noticed no wind at all today. Are you planning on changing something, maybe to try something for the final or just a regular set as you did so far?
No, just feel how it is, feel my body, feel just regular set, feel everything out, yeah.
All right, perfect. Thank you, Jacob. We let you get focused. Best of luck, and back to you, Tony.
Why, thank you there, and here is Matteo Lotteri, 11.25 meters. Important that he gets a decent start and gets into rhythm. He's early enough into two. Little bit of an aggressive fight there on three, but managing to stay there, ski behind him on four. But continuing to assert his will out there on the course on 11.25 meters there, Ali.
Yeah, so a pretty good pass. I mean, we talked a lot yesterday about how that gate down there seems to be what a lot of the skiers are struggling with. So I think it will be interesting to see him take the 10-7 from the other side. Maybe the other gate shot will be beneficial to him to get through that 10-7.
And right you are. One or two instances where the ski was bouncing a little bit towards the end of that turn. Maybe he's trying to push on that ski just a little early and it's the ski is just not having it.
Yeah, I think you saw it most there at three, got it in a little deep there at five, but overall not too much of a problem there for Matteo.
All right, so now it comes down to what, 10.75 meters now from a relatively new direction. Now he's attempted 10.75 meters before. Now, this direction that he's using doesn't have that narrow gap and it doesn't have like the shallow water that's associated by being that close up to shoreline. So maybe he'll have a better start this time around and get a little deeper down the course.
Yeah, so Matteo's best score right now is 3.5 here at this past 10-7. So he's looking to improve on that and hopefully get all six and get a shot at that 10-2-5.
Right you are. Here we go. This is 10-7-5. Start is decent, not the best, but he's still on top of his ski, which is the most important thing. He is round number three, continuing to go. Okay. Oh, round number four. This is on and done. That is relief.
Yeah, well done, Matteo. He'll be happy with that. Definitely, you know, kind of get through it, and it's always nice to be able to do that going into the final. It's a little bit of a confidence boost. I think we'll probably see him start with that 13-meter line again. I thought that start looked a lot better than his starts yesterday.
Well, why reach for Alka-Seltzer when you can get relief by taking six buoys at 10.75 meters? Oh, what a relief it is.
Yeah, so, I mean, like I said, Matteo should be very happy with that. We'll see what he can do here at 10.25, see if he can shake up the leaderboard a little bit. We've got a couple stacked up there at two, and then Will coming through with the four at 10-2-5 from first round yesterday.
Okay, so it's game on now. He can actually move himself significantly lower into the starting order for the championship round if he starts scoring more than about half or one and a half or two, and if he gets past number four. Ooh.
If we see Matteo get past number four, I believe he will be very, very happy. I'm not sure what his best is, but...
They'll be throwing a ticker tape parade for him in San Gervasio. That's what they'll be doing. All right, then. Here we go. We have got Matteo Lotteri, 10.25 meters. Little bit of a bleed of speed coming into number one. Gets round that... Oh, look at him go round number one. He gets the two... And it's now going to be a real toss-up as to how far he goes down that running order because he's tied several ways with several skiers with two at 10.25 meters. He still rolls his eyes, though, but it's a darn sight better than what he scored in the previous round. He should maybe take stock heart with that.
I think still on that gate, though, if you look, it seems like he's almost leaning away from the boat all the way until his turn.
And that's the kind of thing that he was doing on 10.75 from that direction in the previous two rounds.
Yeah, and I was talking earlier, I think that that gate almost, it might even be just that it's a little narrow. I think the skiers may be coming up a little early on that gate just because it feels like we're coming into shore and then slowing down too fast. So they're trying to get that extra lean away to try to be as wide and as fast as they can when they turn in.
Has that been your experience a little bit, Bea?
Yeah, I agree with Ali. I think that's what happened there. But I mean, he was rolling his eyes. I think because he was like finally, you know, I skied as I wanted.
A little bit, you know, yeah. Like, okay, well, there okay. We go. That's yeah. A little bit better, right?
There yeah. We go. It took two rounds, but I got it done.
Yeah, but one thing that, yeah, I was gonna say, one thing that will be interesting is that it should move him up because he will have a backup score, whereas some of the others, I know, like Freddie, for example, has that tie of two, but he did not ski second round yesterday, so he won't have a backup score.
Unless he skis today.
Correct, unless he skis this third round today.
All right then, so let's have a look and see. We know that Matteo Lazzari has vaulted himself up from ninth to third, just like that. And introducing you once again, I've got Ali Nicholson to my left and on the right of your screen, and to my right and on the left of your screen is Beatrizia Jani.
Ciao.
Ciao. And let's say ciao to Lorenzo's land one more time.
Welcome back to the dock. We're here with Corey. So, Corey, we just saw you doing a little commentating with Tony. How was that?
It was good. I felt like my hair was maybe better up there because it was under a hat. So I'm ready to jump in the lake here.
All right, perfect. So how do you feel about conditions today? How do you feel about today?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it looks great. It was just like this all week. Apparently, yesterday was like a 5 days a year are windy here like that. So I'm glad for the finals day. Looks like we're settling down. That's what the event deserves, and we're going to try to make the most of it.
All right, perfect. Thank you very much, Corey. We'll let you get focused. Best of luck, and back to you, Tony.
Yeah, that's interesting to hear from Corey that it only gets that windy and that adverse only about three, four, five times out of the season. Remarkable that it happened yesterday.
Always seems to be a bit of our luck here, you know. We sometimes get the strangest weather at these tournaments, but that's part of being an outdoor sport, you know. You never know what you're going to get.
Indeed. Did you just quote Forrest Gump?
Oh, I don't know about that. Life is like a box of chocolates.
You just don't know what you're going to get. All right, then. Here we go. 30-meter start for Jakob Bonja. And That is just style to just behold.
Yeah, like we said yesterday, this just, I mean, he just looks so relaxed here. So much time before the buoys, nice and calm.
And let's go over to Lorenzo's land.
All right, everybody, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Matteo, who finally posted a nice score, and we see him really happy. So, Matteo, how was it out there?
It was perfect today. It was literally perfect. I wish I would have taken 13 yesterday, to be honest. 10.7, I don't know how it looked, but it felt great. And then a two ball, for those of you that watched last weekend, I did 1.5 and didn't make the final. So today was a great approach to two, but I decided to zigzag and secure a two, which is my highest score this year.
All right, perfect, Matteo. So I see that you're in mental state that it's better than yesterday. See you ready for the final. So go get rested, get focused, and back to you, Tony.
Why, thank you. Yeah, I didn't realize that was his best score of the season. What do you reckon to that, Bea?
Yeah, I think he wanted to keep it like easy, just to have a good score for the season.
All right, and we got Corey Vaughn, and just taking in the atmosphere here with the EDM music in the background, you know, and the throngs of people around the dock area. You just don't get this anywhere else.
I hear there's quite the show coming for the final, so
yeah,
stay tuned.
Yeah.
All right then. Yes, we've been promised an absolutely scintillating finals, and here we go. Here comes Jakob. 12 meters. Number one shouldn't be too hard for him. Water certainly not moving as much as it did yesterday with the wind conditions the way they were. But still, even in that instance, he was able to get through 12 meters, and he does the same right here, Ali.
Yeah, another nice, easy pass for Jakob. So hopefully, you know, see him get down and hopefully get another score into that 10-2.
All right, so Looking forward to seeing him ski, coming back on 11.25 meters. Let's talk a little bit about you, Abeya, and your performance out there. How do you think you did out there with your attempt at 11?
I went a little bit. I was a bit slow at my gate, so I gained speed just like in the wakes. So I went like 100 kilometers per hour on the first ball. So yeah.
Just like turning in for the gates and not getting much rotation, yeah. to set yourself up for one.
Yeah, I think that's what happened. So, but still, 3:11. It's quite nice result for me. So it's okay. I hope later I'm gonna do better.
Well, good. I'm glad to help. There you go. There is Corey Vaughn out of Bumpus in Virginia, and getting ready for his turn out there on the water. But we have to wait and see what Jakob can produce out of Sweden. A little on the back of the ski, but that doesn't really seem to harm his rotation going in towards his 135 side, which is his offside. Nice. And seems to be skiing with a lot more aggression than this in this third and last round, and this third round before we go into the championship round, Ali.
Yeah, so this is kind of the last, this is the last round to try to improve your score for your seeding going into the final. It's also kind of the last round that doesn't really affect you. So I think this is the best round to kind of try stuff and try to feel it out and, you know, be at your best for the final. So.
Right you are. Jakob doing a grand job out there, Petrici.
Yeah, I really like the way he skis. He's a bit on the back of the ski always, but I think it's the way he skis. You just turn and then push on that back foot and just go on top of the ski right in front of the buoy.
Certainly backside in that particular run. So he's gone through 13, 12, and 11.25 meters just like that. And 10.75 meters. Well, let's have a look at some of the scores he's produced with the obvious down score being yesterday with two at 10.75 meters. He got one and one at 10.25 meters in the round before that. So a little bit hot, a little bit cold. Let's see if he can conjure up a performance that will put him back towards the top seeds going into the championship round. Here we go, Jakob. 10.75 meters. Oh, look at this.
Looking like a pretty good start here.
Nice. A little down course off three. But he can afford to do that, providing he has good residual angle. And it checks up on five. And for the second consecutive skier, a 10.75 meter pass. They are really starting to cook out there, Beatrizia.
Yeah, I really liked it. It was like one of the best 10.75 that we had this weekend. A bit down course on that third ball, but he managed to run it easily.
What do you see here, Ali?
No, I mean, I think the ski's coming around really nicely for him here. I think that was a very easy pass, especially coming back after yesterday and his little wipeout that he had. I actually found out after he skied that he had a knot on his head from hitting his ski.
Yeah.
So we were all checking on him last night, making sure that he was okay. But he was in good spirits and seemed to be all right, so... happy to see him back out there today.
And if that knock would have been any harder, he might have actually have had to withdraw from the event due to a concussion protocol, huh?
Yeah. So luckily, I don't think it was quite that bad. I think he, took a little knock, but nothing too bad to be concerned for concussion wise. So happy to see him back out today for sure.
All right. So whilst Corey paces up and down, he's seen two skiers that have run 39 and a half off 10.75 meters.
Well, and I know as a skier standing on the dock, that's always reassuring to see. You like seeing the good scores go up before you. So here we go, 10.25 for Jakob.
All right, here we go. Jakob Bonja coming in to the course. Good start on number one. If he can get past number two.
Oh, come on.
Come on.
Oh, no.
But that should move him up with that backup score of one at 10.2 from yesterday.
That should put him in about, I don't know, about fourth place. Well, It will definitely put him above Matteo Lizzeri, who's currently in third place right now with his two buoy count and backups into 10.75 meters. Jakob Bonja has this score and another backup on 10.25 meters himself. So that should move him above Matteo into third at this time. And just, yeah, he does turn on the back quite a bit, but yeah, he gets the angle there, Bea.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way he skis, I guess. So, yeah, he had a pretty good gait. And then, yeah.
Yep, so another skier through 10.75 meters, another skier getting two at 10.25 meters. So we're kind of wondering where the breakthrough is going to occur with our remaining skiers. We've got the likes of Corey Vaughan coming up. We've got maybe Freddie Winter to ski. I know that Aaron Davies is going to ski. I saw him go past with his equipment. And then you've got Nick Parsons to consider as well, and maybe Philippos Kyprios, although he has probably the best excuse of any for not taking the third and last round, because I don't know whether you've seen Philippos Kyprios, but his left hand is all tore up.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, he hadn't been skiing that much, so he hasn't really conditioned his hands enough to the rigors of shoreline skiing. So he got a blister and it just tore all up down his hand.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
I thought mine was bad, but...
The mark of an aggressive slalom skier. How big are those blisters going to be?
I try to take care of them before they open, because once they're open, I'm a wimp.
Being a medical professional, how do you do that?
Do what?
How best to take care of your hands?
Oh. I mean, mine are looking a little rough right now. I think it's better to proactively, like, tape up than to rip them to shreds and then try to solve it afterwards.
Okay, so preparation's the best medicine.
Yeah, I think taking precautions versus, you know, trying to heal up afterwards.
Yeah, that's true. That's what I didn't do. At all. But yes, too.
And then once they have been blistered, I mean, people swear by some methods, you know, with the emery boards, you know, and rough it up, you know.
My brother has told me to put lemon juice in it. I've never done it, but he says that it burns like crazy,
yeah,
but then once the
does.
Sting is gone, it's there.
Oh, really? I'm going to try it later, after
lemon
the
juice.
Final.
Good luck. Let me know how that goes.
Yeah.
Okay, so free slice of lemon in your cocktail then, I guess, with one of those going on your hands.
Yeah.
There we go. All right, then, here we go. This is Corey Vaughan, 30 meters. Nice and early into buoy number one. Just seems to have that ease of technique and just not breaking into a sweat as yet on 30 meters. Absolutely fantastic looking run there from Corey Vaughan.
I know yesterday, second round, Corey kind of struggled to find his rhythm a little bit. So yeah. I know he's definitely looking to improve on that today and put up a big score in this run.
All right, Aaron Davies looking out and checking out the situation with the conditions. A little bit later on today, when we get into the championship round, we're going to see some... Okay, and for those of you that have just rejoined us, welcome back to the Caiaphas Pro Battle. Apologies for our initial stream leaving us a little bit, and hopefully you guys are aware of that situation and are watching us on our backup stream. So apologies for that, but if you are watching, thank you very much indeed for doing so, and we'll continue on with the competition just to get you up to speed. Jakob scored two at 10.25 meters, so did Matteo, and George Hatzis with a four at 12 meters. Those are the three skiers so far. This is Corey Vaughan on that line length of 12 meters. And let's see what he's got. Looking in good shape though. 12 meters shouldn't really be breaking a sweat as yet, Bea.
Yeah, I mean, it looks better than the second round yesterday. feels like it's more in the rhythm.
And what do you say to that there, Ali?
Sorry. No, yeah, I definitely think he looks a little bit more settled today, so that's good to see for Corey, and we'll see going forward as the rope gets shorter. Hopefully he continues to stay with that rhythm.
All right, and as I was about to say, later on today we're going to see matchups on bplayfuel.com. bplayfuel.com. You can use that and interact with us with the scores and as the final rounds are progressing a little bit later on. So check in with bplayfuel and register with that website, bplayfuel.com. All right, and another part of our interactivity with you good fans out there deals with our skier of the day. If you've seen a performance out there today that qualifies for this this big old trophy here, sponsored by 2U Nutritional Bars, if you've seen something outstanding, vote for it by going to waterskibroadcasting.com/play, waterskibroadcasting.com/play. Here we go, Corey Vaughan, 11.25 meters. Let's see what start he gets. Oh, horrid number two.
He's going to have to fight back here.
But not that hard because he still has a good lead into these buoys already before that point. No, and it's, you know, it's that quicksand analogy. You know, you're in quicksand. You want to get out, obviously. But you can't try too hard or overexert yourself to get out of that that hole there, Beatrice.
Yeah, I mean you're right, but I think he wants to be like sure that he's gonna go like for it later. So he wants to ski good. I mean, I don't want to ski like go back at the dock and I ski like really bad.
Tentative.
Yeah, because he wants to be ready for later, like confident.
Okay, so you're kind of using this as a little bit of a platform to try and test out a few things and see if he can get away with them, Ali.
Yeah, and I think Corey, I believe yesterday, fell there at that two ball, and it kind of looked like a similar two where he found himself in that hole. So fortunately, that was at 11, and he was able to come back from that. He's definitely going to look to clean this up here at the 10.75 to get through it all.
All right. Here we go, Corey Vaughan.
Not the best start here. He's going to have to really work.
Ooh,
broken over there at three.
And stalls up on four, which means that Corey Vaughan gets the four buoy count at 10.75 meters, which by my reckoning puts him in about fifth place at this time.
Yeah, let's see it again.
But a decent start.
Yeah.
However, he just pulled the handle to his inside and he just basically stopped that ski cold.
Yeah, I think it looks to me like he's getting a little disconnected off of that second wake through his edge change. His hands are, I mean, clearly there, his hands are very far away, but they're from the beginning, even at one, and I think that's causing him to have to move back on the ski.
All right, then. With that in mind, let's check in dockside with Lorenzo's Land.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Aaron, our next skier in the water as the boat pulls up. How are you feeling, Aaron?
Feeling all right. You know, the conditions are really, really nice out here today. Just looking forward to getting it done.
So are you feeling a bit sore after that big crash that we saw from you yesterday?
Actually, surprisingly not. I managed to just let it happen. Just kind of kept my limbs under control and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling fine.
All right, perfect. Get ready to get in the water. Best of luck and back to you, Tony.
All right, and Aaron Davies doing a fine job and not only on the water but also on the microphone here with his analysis of the women's competition alongside Corey Vaughan, both of them doing a great job. Maybe that should be the next pairing on playfuel.com. Do the ladies do it better than the guys when it comes to analyzing slalom?
I have a feeling it's probably the guys.
Maybe that's something you can get that situated. Bplayfuel.com, bplayfuel.com. Who are better, the guys or the girls?
I don't want to put a vote.
Me neither.
All right, let's check in dockside with Lorenzo's land.
Welcome back to the dock. We're here with Corey, who just got done skiing. So, Corey, how did you feel out there?
You know, the first couple passes felt all right. And then my start at 11 and 10, not very good with the gate in one. So I'm going to go back and watch the webcast. That's a great benefit we have now. Go pull it back, see what I'm doing a little bit there, get that gate in one dialed in, and get ready for the finals.
All right, perfect. I hear that you're really ready for the finals, so go and watch your set so you can improve on that. Best of luck for next round, and back to you, Tony.
Why, thank you very much indeed, and thank you to all of you that are currently viewing our webcast right now. And we had a little bit of a technical difficulty experienced with the original webcast player. But those of you that are watching right now that have managed to check in and to realize that we switched from one player to the next, thank you very much indeed for doing just that. So, that was Corey Vaughan, and on dockside, we've got Benjamin Stadelbauer, who really came through with a good total yesterday, and actually went for the opt-up from 12 meters all the way through the 10.75 meters yesterday, which was remarkable. Here is Aaron Davies, 30 meters out of the northern English city of Bolton in Lancashire.
We saw Aaron put up the big score yesterday, first round, 2 at 10.25. So I know that he's looking to get through that 10.7 again today.
All right then, let's check in dockside with Lorenzo.
All right, welcome back to the dock. We're here with Benny, who's going to be our last skier for today's third round. So Benny, how are you feeling?
Yeah, good. It was a really fun day of skiing yesterday, and then we're back out here for a beautiful day here in Caiaphas. So yeah, might as well take the advantage of it. Yeah.
Yeah, very good, very good. Benny, another quick question. I see on your binding, you're bringing snow ski equipment on water ski. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, just always work in progress, man. So it never looks the same, but little by little, you know, you get to where you need to be. And I think bindings are personal, so it's just whatever you feel comfortable with, mainly.
All right, perfect. Thank you very much, Benny. Get focused for this round, and back to you, Tony.
Why, thank you. That was a little bit of a discussion that we had yesterday, right, with the short track speed skating boot.
Yeah, so very interesting. I mean, like he said, I think it's everybody likes their own thing. A lot of skiers you see with the back kicker. I cannot ski with a back kicker to save my life. So, yeah, I think boots are very personal. It's all about personal preference and what you like, so... for him, that short boot seems to work.
All right, let's have a look. Aaron Davies, 12 meters. It's gone through 13. This is 12.
Looking nice and easy here for Aaron. You know, just getting kind of dialed in, getting his warm-up passes in.
It seems to work his hips very, very far forward over the tip of his ski, going into 2.46 there, Rebea.
Yeah, I mean, it looked like he was pretty nice in the pass.
Indeed, indeed. So as Nathan McGarry drops him down towards the opposite end, and Benjamin Stadelbauer, who is actually going to be our last skier out in this round.
Yeah, so very interesting. That means we're missing quite a few here.
We're missing Nick and Philippos. So we're missing out on Freddie Wintu, who skied one round so far. He's still trying to heal his back, mind you. Aaron Davies is on the water, Benjamin Stadelbauer out in the water, and Will Asher will not take to the water in this round. But rest assured, in the final, all of them will take to the water.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll see everybody come back. That is the one advantage, I guess, here is everybody's moving through. So I think some of them are just choosing to save up some energy, save their hands and whatnot, save it all for the final round so they can come out and be the strongest and the most ready that they can be.
Absolutely. So there is your leaderboard, taking all of the scores into account. Still shows Will Asher in the lead with 4 at 10.25 meters. Maybe someone like Benny or even Aaron could attack that score. 4 at 10.25 meters, incidentally, is the course record here. And that was set several years ago, and it was equaled yesterday by Will Asher. Aaron Davies looking very aggressive, looking very sprightly on that ski, and doing a fine job out there, Bea.
Yeah, it was a great pass. I mean, looked like no problem at all. He was doing great. He was confident. So, yeah, we'll see at 10.75.
And that confidence definitely shows. I mean, he's been confident all the way through. I mean, he was the second skier out in the first round, Ali, and posting up two at 10.25 meters. That's the kind of confidence you can't buy.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's always nice to go out and put up that big score early on. And, you know, it's kind of just like, all right, you know, like we're capable of it. This lake's capable. Like everything feels great. It kind of gives you the confidence going forward. I definitely think that it's much better than going out and, you know, trying to get that better score every round. Yeah. You know, like being able to start off with that first round gives you that bit of confidence that you're able to build on moving forward.
Right, you are. So Aaron Davies, he's gone through 13 and 12 and now 11.25 meters. Now, 10.75 meters. Let's see what kind of start he gets. He's from the more favorable end for taking in more challenging starts, because at the end that he just came from, it kind of narrows out and goes wide very, very quickly. Here, the shoreline view is very, very constant. Here we go. This is 10.75 meters. Look at him go. Drops in hard on number three. Still on top of his ski round number four. Ladies and gentlemen, ooh, another skier into 10.25 meters, and that is Aaron Davies.
Oh, great.
Shoulder must be hurting after that one.
Probably.
I would like to see this one again in slow-mo here, the replay.
So would I. And we've had now one, two, three skiers out of five that have gone into 10.25 meters. That's a remarkable percentage.
So we had a pretty good start here.
Yeah.
We see that banner up at the top, score under review.
They probably are checking the exit or...
I would say they're taking a look at six ball here.
Okay.
Handle high there out of five. He worked really hard to get over to six.
Yeah, he got round six.
Yeah,
he's round six. Yeah, and he's through the exit gates too. Now, I don't know if there's like a rule on how much displacement you can make against the actual exit ball going out, whether you're riding through it or displacing it that way will prevent you from scoring the pass. Something we need to research, but it looks like he's coming into the course at 10.25 meters, so that becomes a moot point. Here comes Aaron Davies, 10.25 meters.
So he is looking to get a piece of three here to better his score and to move himself up on the leaderboard.
Yeah, putting him ahead of Benjamin Stadelbauer. He's round number, oh, look at that, off balance round number one. He's good to go.
Come on,
get after it. Does he get the three?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, he gets the three.
Nice.
That's his best score of the season.
And I believe that ties his all-time best as well.
Oh, really?
I believe his best was 3.2, was the best of the year. We'll have to ask him whenever he comes in. Aaron will be extremely happy with that score. He was a little off balance there at one, but seemed to handle it well.
Yeah.
Man, look at the ski come around there at two.
He really wanted it.
Yes, he did. I mean, based upon round number one, he really wanted that ski. Now, does he get to it?
Yes.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yeah.
He just squeaks that ski inside.
Great, great job.
And that puts him in second place.
Phenomenal skiing there for Aaron.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll be happy.
Yeah, I bet he is.
After last week's excursion to San Gervasio and getting so close to making it through to the head-to-head section, this is definitely a big old shot in the arm there, Bea.
Sorry, I was looking at Aaron.
Yeah, just looking at the instant replay, and now he was... just look at how close that was. Just centimetres. So a really, really good dose of encouragement, a big shot in the arm there, Bea.
Sorry, I was distracted.
I can understand that, Bea. I know, you're a big fan of Aaron Davies out there skiing, distracted with his skiing. So I'll ask you the same question and see if I can get a solid answer. Big shot in the arm, yes?
don't really know that phrase, but yeah, I mean, I think that's a big, yeah, definitely a big boost of confidence going into the final. Always happy to go and put up a big score, especially if that was tied to his PB. I know that Aaron will be ecstatic with that, and I'm sure he is ready for the dockside interview down in Lorenzo's land. So let's go to them.
Let's get after it.
Welcome back, everybody, to the dock. We're here with Reno, just tied his personal best. So how you feel about that run?
It was okay. You know, I had to battle through my 10-7 to get outside that six ball. You know, it was really close at the end, a little bit like last week. Managed to get around it, though, this time. And just like, right, let's just get a good start on 41. I kind of got my hips back into one, but I managed to come out of it okay, surprisingly. I was like, right, here we go. Make it to three and managed to just squeak around it.
Oh, yeah, you definitely did make it to three. Congratulations on that. Go get your breath for finals, and we'll see you later. Back to you, Tony. Go Cajuns.
There you go. Yes, yeah, so just a brief reminder of where he skis from, the Raging Cajuns of Louisiana Lafayette. And, you know, if it were up to me, I'd give him this plate right now. But it isn't up to me. It's up to you guys.
So
vote now by going
to
waterskibroadcasting.com/play if you think that that is the performance of the competition so far, courtesy of Aaron Davies with three buoys at 10.25 meters. That prize being brought to you by 2U. Go vote for your skier of the day, waterskibroadcasting.com/play. Last skier out, this is Benjamin Stadelbauer, who yesterday absolutely shocked everyone by opting up from 12 meters all the way through 11.25 meters all the way through 10.75 meters.
Yeah, that definitely makes it interesting for the crowd and makes it fun. So exciting to see him do it. Even more exciting to see him get through it. So we'll see what we see from him here. It doesn't seem like there's that much wind. There's a little bit of a breeze, but I don't think it'll be enough to for him to opt up again today.
Oh. Yeah, there's a little breeze. And I think it's quite good for the skiers, this breeze, because it's not hot, it's not like strong as yesterday, but I think it helps.
It puts a little bit of texture on the water.
Exactly, yeah, that's what I was going to say. It gives you just a little bit of texture, just a little bit of, I think it makes it a little better than you don't quite see the water moving so much. So.
Yeah, it keeps the ski gripping to the water a little bit easier, a little bit of more adhesion there to the deal. So, as we continue to roll along, just a quick reminder once again about 2U. The official skier of the day sponsor, nutritional bars in a variety of different flavors, available online and at great local stores across the Sunshine State of Florida. That is 2U Bars. And also, let's check in with La Guapa, located in Tequesquitengo in Mexico. Luxury villa resort with all kinds of amenities, including all-inclusive skiing. You can find out more by going to laguapa.com.mx. laguapa.com.mx. to find out more about that resort facility. So now we have got Benjamin Stadelbauer out there on the water, coming to us originally out of Geneva in Switzerland. And he'll be representing Switzerland in the men's slalom at the World Games in a few days' time. So some encouraging skiing there from the Swiss slalom superstar himself, Benjamin Stadelbauer. What do you see here, Bea?
Well, he's having like this second pass, like nice and easy. He has a good control of the rope. He's always connected to it.
I really like the way that his ski is coming under the line here, on both sides, keeping the line tied at the back side of the buoy. Another, you know, nice and easy pass for Benny, but definitely a technique that will carry through for the shorter line lengths.
Indeed, indeed, and certainly a skier who likes to tinker a lot with fin settings, with skis, you know, flex patterns and whatnot. He's probably on his fifth or sixth ski of the season based upon all of the stuff he's been doing up to this point.
Well, even on his dockside interview, he mentioned, you know, always changing, always improving, and I think that that's definitely the mindset that Benny takes to his approach in skiing, and he's always looking for the next best thing and trying to constantly evolve and improve.
But you've always got to change, though, with an aim in mind, you know, to make the ski come round a little bit cleaner, a little smoother off the end of the turn, maybe a little bit more cross-course traction, that kind of stuff, a little bit stiffer layup. Changing your ski and changing for change's sake isn't always the best policy.
No, I don't think that just tinkering just to tinker is necessarily the best policy, but Benny knows, is extremely well-versed in what he's doing and the changes that he's making. So I know it is a little bit of trial and error, but Benny's definitely, he is always moving and changing with a goal in mind.
And especially off that number five into number six bay, you just got a real hint from Benjamin Stadelbauer that he's not backing off. I mean, he comes off number five. Normally a lot of people at that point would check up and, ease their way to six, but he was still on full aggression mode, Bayer.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes, it's good just to keep focus, and even from the fifth to the sixth boy, just not relax too much.
Yeah, because you don't want to put yourself in a situation of complacency, do
yeah.
you?
No, of course not.
Indeed. Okay. So number four, round number five. And just look at this. Look at that. And that's his offside into six.
Yeah, I just wanted to turn that six ball.
He certainly did. Behind that Nautique by Correctcraft. And we thank all of you folks out here for tuning in. We also like to thank our sponsors who you'll see on the front of this stage here. They've certainly been instrumental in providing us with the resources necessary to make this competition and indeed the webcast of this competition possible here at Kaiaphas on the western Peloponnesian coast of Greece.
Good job pronouncing that.
Peloponnesia. Yes, back in the days of ancient Greece.
So here we go, Benny, 10-7. Let's see if he can get through it again for this round. Looking like a pretty good start here. Little on the back there at two ball, though. Oh, no.
Oh, horrid three.
Oh,
and he goes down at 3.5, which means the winner of this round is Aaron Davies. But at this point, is he gonna easily shrug that off, or is he just gonna say okay?
No, I think Benny will shrug that off and come into the finals clear-headed and ready to put up a big score. So the finals are going to be very interesting. I mean, we saw several of the men get through 10-7 that time for the first time. So, yeah.
All right, then. So as Benjamin Stadelbauer swims in after 3.5 at 10.75 meters, that will bring to a conclusion the third round of skiing. We've got the championship round, which will take place, I believe, what time did they say?
I saw it pop up on the screen.
At 1 p.m. So 1 p.m. Eastern European summertime is when we will rejoin with the broadcast. Right now it is 11:25 in the morning here, Eastern European summertime. So in about an hour and a half, then we will be back with more great professional skiing. My name's Tony Lightfoot. You've heard Beatrizia Jani, and we've also heard from Ali Nicholson. And if you want to vote for the best analytical team in water skiing, whether it's the girls or the guys, go to beplayfuel.com, beplayfuel.com. Vote for your best pairing, whether it's the girls or the guys. But in the meantime, until we rejoin the broadcast at 1 p.m. right here on TWBC, it is Ciao for now.